The name's James Bond. Welcome back to Extreme Game Facts, where today we're going to be covering the 1995 classic Goldeneye for Nintendo 64. Goldeneye for Nintendo 64 originates from its movie counterpart, which came out earlier in 1995. It starred Pierce Brosnan as James Bond, the super assassin bent on revenge. The innovative aiming mode was one of Goldeneye's biggest achievements. Players could more precisely aim their crosshair at enemies for better shots. Goldeneye was a revolution when it first released, marking a new era of first-person video games on consoles, which were previously only released on IBM PC computers. For the first time, players were able to relive the thrilling scenes of the original blockbuster, which made it one of the most popular games of its time. The reasoning behind the Goldeneye name is simple. It's a reference to how the main villain, Alex Trevelyan, has a prosthetic eye colored gold. It's also the name of the weapon that is ultimately controlled by this fake eye. Goldeneye originally began its development as a Super Nintendo game, but due to limited hardware, it could not be finished since a first-person shooter was simply not possible on Super Nintendo. Players know of a so-called spider weapon, which was seen in early developmental screenshots. This weapon is featured in the final game, with its name changed to Klob, derived from Rareware COO Kevin Lobb. Goldeneye was also innovative for its stealth mechanics that allowed players to take a quieter path through levels, lest they wanted to avoid fighting too many enemies. The game was developed by Rareware, who were previously known for their Donkey Kong games. The inventor of the company, David Doak, is featured in the game as a scientist you must rescue in the second stage. The face of Donkey Kong can be spotted against one of the mountains at the end of the dam level. Donkey Kong was a game that Rare also worked on, which would explain why it's referenced in this game. Sometimes, players can wreak havoc on an intended scenario. Uh-oh, that's not supposed to happen. A face-swapping feature was planned for the game, but it never came to fruition due to technical problems. Players would have been able to make distinct combinations of characters, such as Oddjob's head on Natalia's body. In the bunker level, you can find a VHS tape that has the cover of the feature film. For those not in the know, VHS tapes were an old format in which we used to watch videos. Goldeneye is famous for its cheat codes that can be unlocked by beating levels as fast as possible. Fan favorites include ×2 Laser, Silver PP7, and Line Mode. Originally, the much-praised multiplayer mode was originally made in 5 seconds as a test. Rare must have been surprised when this feature took off. Pictures exist of other James Bond actors, such as George Lazenby, being featured in the video game. Using a cheating device, such as a game genie, can reveal these unused textures. One developer commented, jokingly, saying, "It's almost like needing a game genie to get out of bed." The controversial multiplayer character, Oddjob, has often been criticized due to his small size. The developers confirm using this character is in fact cheating, because you have to use cheats to unlock him in the first place. There is a secret paintbrush weapon that can be accessed on the first board with a special button combination. This is undoubtedly a reference to Bob Ross, a popular painter of the 90s. Due to having to race to beat levels and unlock the cheats, this game can be seen as the inventor of speedrunning. Now that's cool. Goldeneye was one of the first games to feature holding two guns at once. However, this would eventually be more popularized by Halo, which was more advanced and had better graphics. The AK-47 weapon featured in the game happens to resemble a Duracell battery with the low-fidelity graphics. Many fans have noticed this and pointed it out over the years, including Duracell themselves. The secret level, Aztec, is regarded as one of the hardest video game levels ever made. Later on in the level, you fight Jaws, who has 2 machine guns. Watch out! A mysterious island can be spied from the edge of the dam. For over 20 years, the purpose of this island went unsolved, until a spokesperson from Rare finally identified it to be a remnant of the secret Citadel map. This map was intended to be the final boss, but due to time constraints, Rare had to make it inaccessible to players. Once again, the game genie can reveal these long-forgotten secrets. The civilians you see in the street stage wear red shirts, intended as a joke in reference to disposable civilians in J.J. Abrams' Star Trek series. A sequel was produced in 1999 called Goldeneye 2. This game was exclusive to PlayStation and featured a different gameplay style that didn't win over audiences. Goldeneye was cleverly referenced in the Nintendo 64 title Turok 2 Dinosaur Hunter. In that game, you fight a boss that is literally titled the Golden Eye. A sneaky reference from Acclaim. A remake of the game came out in the late 2000s under the name of Goldeneye Reloaded. It features better graphics and a retold story. It can be downloaded for free online. Once again, gaming fans, thank you for tuning into Extreme Game Facts. Remember to like and subscribe, leave a comment, send a friend request, and share this on Etsy, MySpace, Danduru, Metal Archives, Zanga, LiveJournal, and Boing Boing.